ISUPK.
Commander Jenny Johanna, we are not affiliated with any other Israelite group on the face of the planet Earth. If it is in the UPK, it is in the Lord's way, man. We out here teaching that Blacks, Natives, and Hispanics are the chosen people of the Most High, and that the white man is the devil that the Bible speaks of, man. You understand? There's a lot going on over there on the borders right now, dealing with Donald Trump. You understand him raiding our Hispanic brothers, our Mexican brothers over there on land that was theirs, man. You understand? We're going to bring it out today, out here in Isaiah 14 to 21, man. Donald Trump and white America has no peace about them, man. You understand? They have no peace about them, man. There's no peace. The scriptures say there's no peace for the wicked, man. There's no peace for these murderers, man, for these molesters, for these pedophiles, man. There's no peace for them, man. You understand? There's no peace for these liars, man. No peace for these deceivers. You understand? There ain't no woman, ain't no peace for these heathens either, man. You understand? The scriptures say that they should go into captivity, man, for their crime. And what they did against Blacks and Hispanics, man, and the Native brothers, man. We're going to bring it out to Isaiah 14:21, man. I know you are.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 21. Prepare slaughter for his children for the iniquity of their father.
Prepare slaughter for his children for the iniquity of their fathers, man. You understand? You white people talking about we not the same as the ones that put us into slavery. That's a goddamn lie, man. You understand? The scriptures say that y'all should go into, y'all gotta go into captivity, man. You understand? You gotta pay for what your fathers did, man. And fellas, who's gonna pay for that, man? Just like debt is settled, the debt goes down to your next of kin and the next person. Yeah, the crimes of y'all forefathers got, somebody gotta pay for those, man. You understand? Donald Trump got some nerve to be talking about the 9/11 victims, their income is never gonna go out, man. You understand? The 9/11 victims, their income is never gonna go out. The money's gonna keep flowing in for the ones that were traumatized from that event on 9/11, man. For what happened, that terrorist attack on 9/11. You understand? But we gotta ask, what about the victims of abortion, man? What about the victims of the transatlantic slave trade, man? You understand? What about the victims that's over there on the borders right now, the Mexican brothers and sisters that's drinking out of toilets? You understand? What about the victims, the children that's being laid in cages with no blankets and no food? You understand? The white man is a man of numbers, man. You understand? I'm gonna read it from the top one more time.
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 21. Prepare slaughter for his children, for the iniquity of their father.
You understand? The white man's not gonna be able to pay to get out of the reparation that the Lord is gonna bring, man. You understand? Christ is coming back to roll these white people's heads, man, and roll these other nations' heads, man, for their crimes and what they've done against the Lord's children, man. You understand? The scriptures say prepare slaughter. You understand? Prepare slaughter for the Lord's children, for the iniquity of their fathers, man, for the crimes and the sins of their fathers. You understand? That the Blacks, Natives, and Hispanics have never gotten any justice for, man. You understand? And we stupid enough to go to the white man to relieve our oppression and our poverty, man. But they can't do so more if they're the one that's killing us, man. You understand? You understand? The scripture say prepare slaughter for them, man. The white man not gonna be able to buy his way out of. The white man was smart. You understand? He'd have been saving up. He'd have been saving up his 401k plan. He'd have been saving up everything, his vacation plans, and everything else and above. if he wanted to buy his way out of what is prophesied in these scriptures, man. But the white man on that day is not going to be able to use their precious dollar to get out what the Lord has in store for them, man. It's true reparations that's coming down for the blacks, natives, and Hispanic community, man. You understand?
Isaiah chapter 14, verse 21. Prepare slaughter for his children, for the iniquity of their fathers.
Right, exactly. Prepare slaughter for the iniquity of their fathers, man. For their children, man, for what they did. Somebody got to pay for these, man. You understand? And the white people today ain't too different from the ones back then, man. We still getting lynched and robbed and everything stolen from us in the same day, man. The same thing that's going on today is the same thing that's going on back then, man. You understand? Ain't nothing new under the sun. The same things that happened to blacks in the Hispanic community. The white man still kicking down every Hispanic door, trying to deport them across the border. And the white man is still kicking down every black neighborhood and every hood and every project to get you out of there and gentrify it. You understand? That's why D.C. used to be the chocolate city. But now they ain't the chocolate city no more. Now it's like vanilla city. It's a diverse of ice creams. Black, it's chocolate, vanilla, and strawberry, man. It's a variety and a diversity when it used to be chocolate city, man. You understand? If you don't believe me, just look at every single hood and every single project and see if you don't have them having a construction plan and a blueprint to get that hood and that project up out of there, man. You understand? The white man is vicious, man. And the scriptures say his words are as smooth as butter. You understand? But in his heart is war, man. You understand? The white man seeks to devour us, man. They're our enemy, man. Black people, we need to wake up and understand that the white man is our enemy, man. And we got to unite together, man. In brotherhood, in fear of the Lord, we got to unite together, man. You understand? You can drop that. Give me Isaiah 10:1. You understand? We got to ask, what about y'all? Y'all talking about the 9/11 fund for those victims that's never going to go out. But I ask, when did the fund start for the Native American Indian brothers on the Trail of Tears with Andrew Jackson? When did that fund start? When did the fund start for the transatlantic slave trade? You understand? But the 9/11 victims got a fund that's never going to go out. You understand? White America has no respect. They have no respect for the blacks, natives, and Hispanics who own this land. You understand? Who are the chosen people of the Most High, man? You got that? We're going to bring it out right here.
Isaiah chapter 10, verse 1. Woe unto them that decree unrighteous decree.
You understand? Woe unto them. What does woe mean? War, discretion, pain. You understand? You understand? It says, woe to them. You understand? Death to them. That what?
Woe to them that decree unrighteous decrees and that right grievousness which they have prescribed.
You understand? The right grievousness which they have prescribed, man. You understand? Woe unto them, death unto them, man. They sit here and talk about what's happened, let alone that they don't even tell the whole truth. You understand? They tell 1 out of 10 of the truth. You understand? They write about it when it's their fault. They got every law in their books about drugs when the drugs is their fault. They got every law in the world about murder when they're the ones that murder every single day on a daily basis. Some of us got to wake up on the wrong side of the bed. The white man is naturally born on that side of the bed, man. They naturally want to kill and they naturally want to murder. They naturally want war against you, black man, Hispanic man. They naturally want war against you. They want you to see that they want you on the bottom of their feet at all times. You understand? And we got to understand that we can do it with unity and with brotherhood, man, in the ISUPK, man. We can do it, man. Read that from the top.
Isaiah chapter 10, verse 1. Woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees and that right grievousness which they have prescribed.
And what's right grievousness which they have prescribed, man? Death to them, man. The white man got a whole lot of mouth and a whole lot of paper to write down everything else in the world but the truth, man. You understand? And they just sold some of our so-called black leaders into telling us lies as well, man. The white man is so devious that they can turn our own into lies as well, man. You understand? We got to accept the truth of what the truth is, man. You understand? We can't negotiate what the truth is, man. We can't sit here and go back and forth and debate about the truth. There's only one truth, man. And the truth is that the white man is the devil that the Bible speaks of, man. The truth is that the white man is your enemy, black man. You understand? The scriptures say that you're the salt of the earth, man. You understand? The scriptures say you're the salt of the earth. This sister can sing. This brother and sister can dance. This brother and sister got so much talent in the world. So why are we the lower class system? How we consider the poor, but we spend every single one of our dimes on the white man's objects, man. And they're nothing but crimes and molesters, man. But and rapists, man. You understand? They got us acting a fool, shacking a fool out here when we should have some common sense to stay away from these devils, man. Read verse 2 for me.
Verse 2. To turn aside the needy from judgment.
To turn aside the needy from judgment, man. You understand? Trump doesn't tell his judges, hey, give them people a righteous judgment, man. Give them people some justice, man. For their loved ones, man. You giving judgment and relief off of them white Americans that suffered from 9/11, right? But you're not telling your judges and your courthouses, right, that use the Bible in there and want to put their hand up and say, on God. But they're not the ones that's giving us any type of relief, any type of justice, man, for the crimes that they have done, man. Read verse 1 again.
Woe to them that decree unrighteousness, unrighteous decrees, and that right grievousness which they have prescribed.
Right. The white man writes grievances what they have prescribed, man, and they don't give, as the scripture to say, they don't give the needy a righteous judgment. You understand? A righteous relief, something that's going to heal them. What does the white man do? The white man uses his lust and think that we want that and fool us into thinking that that's what we want. You can't pay us millions of your green dollars for our loved ones that you slaughtered in the middle of the street on camera. You can't pay that off, man. And any black person that agrees with that, you're lost, man. Following Christianity and white America, man. You understand? You can't pay for the loved ones, man, that you done suffered and shot with no gun on their person. Harmless. Their hands up in the air, hands are out of the window. You understand? They frozen to a pulp. You understand? Because they used to y'all shooting us, man. A white person would say, you should love everybody. A pastor Porkchop would say, you should love everybody. You understand? But instead of asking me, why do I hate them? I'ma ask you, why should I love them? Why should I give my love to white America? Why should I give my love to anybody that's not black, native, or Hispanic? You understand? Anybody that's not going through oppression, anybody that's not on this 12 tribes talk right here, why should I give them any of my love when they have not given any of my love to my people? And what will Uncle Tom Coon say? Oh, well, they haven't done nothing to you. What have they done to you? You understand? The scriptures say, you understand? What you doing to them is what you doing to me. What you doing to us is what you doing to Christ, man. You understand? You understand? You feeding me, you feeding our brothers the same thing as you feeding us all back here, man. You understand? Because it's a brotherhood and a unity. But the black community has lost that, man, due to white America and their customs. You understand? Go ahead and drop that. Give me first. You understand? You understand what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? The scriptures say woe to them, man. Death to them that do this, man. You understand? And everybody on the face of the earth know that this Bible right here is the most accurate book on the face of the planet earth. Just like the white man in their school systems can teach you their history books, it's the same thing right here. This is our history books. The white man's books contains his wars and all the slaughter and above. This book's containing as well. You understand? But this is the most accurate book right here, man, for blacks, natives, and Hispanics, man. It tells you when we follow these laws that we'll be in rulership, man. Deuteronomy 28:1, man. You understand? He'll put us above all nations, man. You understand? But in order to do that, we gotta follow what the scriptures say, man. Ecclesiastes 12:10. You understand? You can never trust your enemy, man. First of all, you gotta understand who your enemy is, and it's not hard, black man. It's not hard, it's that man, it's that beast that put them drugs in your neighborhood. It's that beast that got your mother and your father on crack and had you grow up hard in the projects and in the hood, hating your brother, man. You understand? Bring it up. I'll bring out what you got.
First Peter chapter 5, verse 8. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour.
Read that from the top.
Be sober, be vigilant.
Be sober, be vigilant. So in other words, man, in context, we gotta be on point. You understand? We gotta be on the surrounding our head on the swivel, man. Because our adversary, the devil, Donald Trump, is looking to kick in every Hispanic door. You understand? Donald Trump is looking to kick in every project in every hood. You understand? To take a black man out of it so that household is not weak. That household is now, I'm able to come in there. The devil's not able to keep in there. A liar is not able to creep in there and tell you, hey, you understand? Hey, you need to be there. You need to go be with this white man. White people are better for you. They're nicer. You understand? They're nicer. They got money. You understand? That's the white man's objective. Take the black man out of it. You understand? The white man see the same thing that was happening over in Egypt when Pharaoh tried to say, kill all the firstborns. You understand? We just kept multiplying through all that oppression. You understand? We just kept multiplying. Donald Trump and white America tried to do everything in the book to kill a black man, to kill a black sister, and to change a black sister's mindset. You understand? Abortion, the deportation and ICE. They tried to do everything to stop you from multiplying and to get you out of a land that they stole, man. You understand? Read that from the top.
Verse Peter to the 5, verse 8. Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may desire to devour.
You understand? As the scriptures say, man, you understand that the devil, you understand, they walketh about on who they may desire, man, like a lion, man, like a crouching lion. You understand? But the white man is showing his flesh out all in the above, man. The brother was bringing that out earlier. We rather you just show you already done said it. Don't come back later and say, oh, I didn't mean that. Or y'all take it out of context. You said what you said, man. You understand? Stick to what you believe in. At least we'll know. Oh, Bucks, well, at least we'll know that you're not capping, that you're not trying to sell us a lie, man. But you can't be half and half. You understand? Donald Trump got some nerve to be talking about he the best thing that had happened to Puerto Ricans. You understand? But over here, deporting everything Hispanic in the world, man, off of land that they was theirs, man, and slaughtering everything in their path, man. The white man is vicious, man. The vile beast of the earth and the depth and the devil that the Bible speaks of, man. You understand? And the white man don't care who you are, man. If you a black man that's in a suit, or you a black man that ain't got but one shoe on, he's still seeking to devour you. It don't matter if you young, it don't matter if you old, man. The youth or the elder, man. How do we know that's true, brother? How do we know that's true? You see the cops, the white man putting a plastic bag around an 8-year-old, man, on his head for selling CDs and lemonade for 50 cents. You understand? You see a cop shooting 3 kids in the head, and they still got their job. They don't pay leave. They get moved to a better location for them, to comfort them. A cop is supposed to be trained to handle these situations, but yet every single one of these stories, they're coming out about how they were startled, how they were scared, how they was this. And every single white video of a white person attacking another cop, they have yet to pull their gun, nor their taser. You understand? They have yet to pull none of that. Why? It got to be something about you, black man and Hispanic man. It has to be something about you, man, and the scriptures say it all. You got that?
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 50. A nation of fierce countenance, which shall not regard the person of old, nor show favor to the young.
You understand? They won't regard the old or the young, man. The youth or the elder, man. The white man doesn't care. Over there, that deportation, they don't care if you're 80 years old drinking out of a toilet, and they don't care if you a newborn drinking out of a toilet, man. They don't care. You understand? So I ask again, why should I care about Donald Trump? Why should black people and Hispanic people care about Donald Trump when we see every day on a daily basis what they do to our people, man? And they walk around with their head and they hands head high. I simply was grabbing gas on the way coming up here to camp to speak today, man. And a white person walking through the door, you understand, and putting their foot in front of me, it's just showing how much privilege that they feel that they naturally have. That I gotta sit here because you're a white lady? I don't care about that. If anything, you hold the door for me and you stand here for the rest of the day. For every single brother and sister that try to walk through here, man. But got nerve to say white privilege don't exist, man. White privilege exists every day in our eyes, man. You understand? A white person will get to a crosswalk and don't look left or right. They don't look left or right no more because they know if you hit me, that's your life. That's your entire family's life. If you even nudge at me, if you do a stop and roll, if your vehicle don't completely stop, you know that's your behind, man. The white man will walk across the middle of this road and everything in a pattern will stop, man. The GPS will know to pause when a white person is walking across the crosswalk, man. You understand? The white man is vicious, man. You understand? Read that one more time, bro.
Deuteronomy 28, verse 50. a fear, a nation of fierce countenance, which shall not regard the person of the old, nor show favor to the young.
You understand? No favor to the young either, man. You understand? The white man has our younger generation doing anything else and above, man. On they drug heavy, man. They doing their drugs like it's mathematics, man. Adding up grams and everything as if it's mathematics, man. When we should be adding up these scriptures.
Who we want?